Okay, and here we are with Lisa Delia with Heidi Gleickoff. I'm not sure where Tunisia is. She said she'd be here by now.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I'm so late. I swear I knew what time this started, but I got a little caught up.
One of the leading ladies in Hofstra University's newest main stage production, The Complete Works of William Shakespeare. Do I have that right, Lisa?
It's actually The Complete Works of William Shakespeare, abridged, revised.
I see. And could you explain that distinction for us, please?
Certainly. So we are performing all of William Shakespeare's plays, hence the complete works, but we are doing it in a very condensed fashion.
Yep.
Hence the abridged.
And then they revised it, and here we are.
Common mistake.
Alrighty, moving right along then. Now, Shakespeare can be very dense, lofty, and sometimes boring for an audience to endure. What compels you and your castmates to want to perform every single one of the Bard's plays?
Well, I mean, I would say that I pretty much know about as much as everyone else does about Shakespeare.
Well, I personally do not believe that any of Shakespeare's plays are boring or dull, or any of those words that you used. I think that they are all wonderfully exciting.
Well, that's honestly why I'm here, right? Like, my presence gives this production so much light.
It's not that hard to understand. I mean, like, kings are all terrible and try to kill people.
But I personally have a very deep connection to William Shakespeare.
And honestly, guys, if you think that it's going to be a snooze fest, don't worry about that, because Tunisia has got you covered.
The women all like to dress like men, I feel that.
I'm just getting excited thinking about it.
To just make Shakespeare more relatable to everybody else, you know?
And then, of course, I wrote my valedictorian speech in iambic pentameter, but nobody noticed.
That, we're just going to knock this one right out of the park.
Okay, we're gonna move right along then. Heidi, can you talk about the strengths of your fellow castmates and how it helps you out?
Sure. Well, I have to say, I really see a lot of myself in their performances.
Well, I honestly help my castmates out a lot. Like, my life to this production is just so great, and I bring so much charisma to it that, you know, I actually see them looking up to me throughout this entire process.
Oh, well, Shakespeare is definitely no walk in the park, and while I do believe I could do a one-woman complete works of William Shakespeare abridged revised, it's definitely great to have the two of them behind me.
I see, but, anything about what they offer?
Oh, I mean, well, they try.
Words roll off their tongue like honey.
And Tunisia is just so committed and enthusiastic about everything. She just definitely loves to learn about the Bard, even if she can be a little emotional at times.
And the way they squeeze the juice out of every line like a fresh fruit. And the way their doublets just kind of cling to their body, it's like they're in a cocoon and they'll blossom into a beautiful Shakespeare butterfly, you know, and just like fly.
Now tell us, what is your favorite play by William Shakespeare?
Oh, there's so many to pick from. Probably have to go with Romeo and Juliet. Not only his most popular, but also his funniest.
Oh man, that's really hard. Okay. Maybe my favorite would be A Midsummer Night's Dream. I don't know, it's just something about it. Like, the way in which it captures the unhinged imaginations of human nature.
Oh my gosh, there's so many to choose from. I don't know. I feel like a mother having to choose her favorite child.
It strays away from the conventional traditions of theater, but it does so in a way to like comment on the dreamlike nature of art itself, which is just so amazing.
But every mother does have their favorite, so gonna have to go with Hamlet.
His funniest?
Oh yeah! Don't tell me you weren't laughing out of your chair when you saw that play. I mean, like, everyone dying in ridiculous and stupid circumstances and the priest in the back that's like, I don't know how to handle all this teenage angst!
Wow, that was really profound, Tunisia. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now what about your least favorite?
Ugh, Hamlet. I fell asleep.
Probably any of the really not very well-known ones, so I'd be like Coriolanus or Cymbeline.
Oh, I have no least favorites, only other most favorites.
Or Love's Labor's Lost, or Pericles, or Timon of Athens, or Merry Wives of Windsor.
And finally for us, Tunisia, why should people come see The Complete Works of William Shakespeare, Abridged, Revised?
Well, I think that people should come see this show because
gonna get a crash course on all 37 plays and 154 sonnets.
We're making the boring ones funny, the funny ones even funnier.
I mean, class can be boring. Sorry, Dr. McFeely.
Yes, people should come see this production because, I mean, it's all that you need to know about Shakespeare. We are the experts, and we are serving Shakespearean knowledge to you on a silver platter in a shorter amount of time than has ever been done in the history of the world.
And honestly, I don't know about you guys, but I could watch a character vomit and die all day long, and that's what Shakespeare is about.
So, what's not to like?
Not everyone has all the energy to look all that stuff up, so why not let a trio of hilarious professionals do it for you?
We are all certainly very, very excited. A very special thank you to the preeminent expert on all things Shakespeare, from the complete works of William Shakespeare, abridged, revised, Miss Heidi Gleickoff, Lisa Delia, and Tanisha Seda,